is. The screen tells me not to. Speaking of screen. There we go. Much better. Alright, I'm gonna sit down here because I'm tired of standing. Hello, Hasbro. You jerks. Takara told me. I love this intro. Seriously, this intro is outright amazing. Like, why can't we just have a Zoid series with nothing but Zoids? Just screw the pilots, just give us the Zoids. Nobody cares about the pilots, only care about the Zoids. The Zoids are the true stars of the show. So this evening. Anyway. Yes, if you haven't guessed by either the title of this video or what I accidentally set out, this is Zoids Battle Legends. Yes, it is me yet again. So, for those who don't know, Zoids Battle Legends is a Nintendo GameCube game released in 2004. There, yeah, I was reading up the little letters, but yeah. So, of course, in this game, of course, you take control of a Zoid, and you, well, battle other Zoids. Simple concept. So, to start off, we have different modes here. We have battle mode, mission mode, versus mode, Zoid's fist, and configuration. Zoid's fist and versus mode are pretty much the same. The only difference is that in battle mode, you fight your opponent 1v1. As in, one-on-one battles, just you versus the opponent. And there's one criticism about this game I am going to give, and you are going to notice this in the frame rate. Zoid's Fist is pretty much the same as Versus, only instead of just destroying your opponent in order to win, you can knock your opponent off of the arena. Configuration is our option, and mission mode is our story mode. Now, I don't know whether or not I want to do the mission mode. Preferably, I prefer not to do the mission mode. I do not want to do the campaign, because the campaign mode is hard as hell. But, I'm pretty certain I'm probably going to have to anyway, so I'll be prepared in case something like that happens. Plus, I'll have a guide on standby. And lastly, we have battle mode, which is the mode we're going to play. It's pretty much tournament mode, and before you ask, no, we're not starting the new game, because I have a save data right here, ready to go. So, remember, do not touch the control stick when loading, or the C-stick. So, in versus mode, which I don't think you can see because my camera is too far close to the TV, so let me just move it back a bit. There you go. There, much better. As you can see, just whenever you start up tournament mode, you're allowed to pick your pilots. We are given an option between variety of different pilots, from New Century Zero to Chaotic Century / Guardian Force, and, well, the ones that actually appear in Battle Legends. Of course, we're allowed to pick the player pilot and the partner pilot. Our partner is going to be Vega because, come on, when you're given the option between one of the other pilots and a skilled one, because really, one thing I'd like to do is have a tendency of doing whenever I play this game is, whenever I go into tournament mode, I'm always playing as the main character, which in this case is Big Cloud, and My partner is always the rival character, which in this case is Vega. And our first opponent is Kirkland and Lineback. Thank you, guitar solo. Kirkland and Lineback and their two Zerafangs in who are part of the Fuzzy Pandas team. I mean, the Tigers team. Yeah, I know. New Century Zero made that exact same joke, and I couldn't resist. So, normally, whenever you start off tournament mode, you'll start off with four Zoids. Four in total. Total. These Zoids in particular being the Command Wolf, the Attack Cat, the... brain fart there. But yeah, your starting Zoids are generally the Attack Cat and the Command Wolf, as well as the Molga and Cannon Tortoise. As you can tell, I've pretty much been playing tournament mode a butt ton, getting a lot of points, so... Now, of course, starting off, you have the farm, you have different entries, you have your settings, your shop, your info, and your system, which is pretty much the save and load game and enter title screen. And then you have your entry, where you can select what Zoid you want to use at the moment. As well as you can, well, do this. You can pretty much swap out whether or not you want to play as a specific... whether or not you want to be the partner pilot or your default player pilot or not. I will be playing this as Berserk Fury, of course, because when given the option between the other Zoids and Berserk Fury hands down. But anyway, thing of note, when you're starting off with tournament mode, I think a lot of people who've played this game will recommend that you sell the Cannon Tortoise and sell the Molga. And then use those points that you gain to purchase a Blade Liger. I say that as I just sold the Blade Liger. I am a hypocrite. I recommend the Blade Liger, yet I sell the damn thing. But anyway, but yeah, if you're starting off, whenever you start off battle mode, sell the other two Zoids that you're not using, because they'll just get in your way, and just, well, purchase the Blade Liger, and then you can sell the Attack Cat and give your partner the Command Wolf, and then you can just grind up points from there. Anyway, showing up the shop later. First, here you have your settings. You're allowed to pick which Zoid you want to... well, use your settings on. You're also allowed to pick the Zoid's weapons, which, depending on the Zoid, will determine how many weapon slots it will have, like in this case. Berserk Fury has three. The default weapon, and two additional weapons that you can add on to it. Then you have the option parts, which I have the shield equipped, because in this case, I'm not going to be needing the thrusters. And then you have your subparts, which, again, you're going to need them. If you hold the Z button, you can check the Zoid's data. One thing of note, you'll notice something called an EX attack. EX attacks are pretty much your special moves, if you will. If you've played something like, say, Street Fighter, or like... I apologize, I just felt like doing that, but anyway. EX are pretty much a Zoid's special moves. In this case, the Berserk Fury's EX move is the Charged Particle Cannon, pretty much a giant death laser. In order to activate this, well, I'll explain how you activate it in battle mode in, well, the actual combat. You can press the L button to remove things, you can hold the R button to check your parts list, and you can also press the X button to change the Zoid's color. So, I'm going to be sticking with white because, well, every single time you see Berserk Fury often depicted, you often see Berserk Fury in a lot of fan art, as well as the motorized Berserk Fury kit, depicts the Berserk Fury with white armor, and I don't know if it's just me, but I distinctively recall Berserk Fury having white armor. The armor color of the Berserker being white in New Century Zero, but lavender in Fusors. But yeah. Next you have the shop, where you can purchase Zoids, or sell Zoids, or weapons, or option parts. Of course, look at all these Zoids. Again, a couple of them you won't be able to obtain until you beat in a specific tournament mode. Not tournament mode. I'm botching what I'm saying. Damn it. Ah. But pretty much, certain Zoids you can't unlock until you, well, beat in a specific tournament. Starting off, we have the New Century Zero tournament, so yeah. You can also purchase weapons for certain Zoids, as well as option parts and subparts. We are going to be purchasing this particular subpart right now to give you as an example. This is the Ultra Z, pretty much the best subpart in the whole game. Increases all your stats except weight. So yeah, that is a pretty good subpart. So when you have the chance, purchase the damn thing. Then you have your map info, of course, which tells you where you're going to be fighting. Of course, we are fighting in the Wasteland, and our opponents are Kirkland and Lineback, two members of the Tigers team in their Zebra Fangs. This, of course, should be easy because we have Berserk Fury. And, of course, my partner has the Strong Tyran. Yes, I know that that name is actually a typo, but I'll explain that later. But, pretty much, this is pretty much how it works. I'm going to set Vega to combat. Yeah, you can set your ally to do certain things by pressing, like, one of the pads. You will notice that, now, you attack by pressing the A button, you jump with the B button, and if you want to use a melee attack, you use the X button for a melee attack, and you press Y to switch weapons. Z, R is pretty much your lock-on button. Ow, 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 ow. Help. Ow. So much pain. But yeah, the C stick is your dodge. R button is your lock-on button. And there we go. That takes out one. HP. And there we go. That wraps up the Tigers team. We win. So yeah. Now, the L button is to unlock on, of course. Now, if you want to use your EX attack, your Zoid has to be below half health. I do mean very below half health. As in, your Zoid has to be at critical health in order to use it, and then you have to stand completely still and hold the A button and the X button simultaneously. Yes, it's a pain to do, but it's satisfying when you manage to pull it off. So whenever I get the chance, I'll probably show it off at some point. Hopefully. Loading. Alright. Our next opponent is in the Gorge. We're fighting against Leon in the Shield Liger. You know, I completely forgot Leon piloted the Shield Liger. And we have Ballad piloting the Command Wolf. Thing of note, his name is actually incorrect. His name in the show is Brad, so that's a misstep on the game's part. Well, more so the writer's part, but, And of course, you know, rather than partner. Thing of note, the Strum Tyran and the Strum Fury. Those are actually typos. Their actual names are Storm Tyran and Storm Fury. And if you haven't guessed by their design, they're pretty much alternate armor set for the Berserk Fury. Then again, I really do like Storm Tyran more than Storm Fury. Mainly for the colors, the red and gold is just amazing. So for those who don't know, the Zoid series is an anime that takes place on the planet Z, where pretty much people pretty much pilot these things called Zoids. And we have our first target. Of course, Zoids are pretty much robotic animals, to be blunt. Yeah, to be blunt, Zoids are basically robotic animals. Robotic versions of different animals, be it living, extinct, or, in the case of specific Zoids, fantasy! Ah, oh, shit. And I accidentally hit my pilot. Partner. Go away. You got a Vega, or not. Stab, 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 and stab. There you go. Shield leg are done. Let's go, Vega. And victory's okay. Fury, what's wrong with your leg? Fury, you're alright. Because you need to get your right leg checked out. And A rank. Yeah, the thing about tournament mode, you're scored based on how much health you have, your time, how much health your partner has, damage to the enemy Zoid, and I think you're also scored on using the EX attack. This was the fight. Okay, so as I was saying before, pretty much there are four Zoid series, there are four Zoids animes currently. Three of the four were released in the US. Those being Chaotic Century, New Century Zero, and Fusors. Those three were all released in the West. They all have English dubbings, but if you want to watch one of the Zoid animes, watch New Century Zero and Chaotic Century. Like, Fusors is not bad, it's just compared to the other two, it's just not as good as the other two. Which is kind of ironic, because I actually rewatched New Century Zero over spring break, so. Note how I said rewatched. The fourth one being Zoids Genesis, but there's no English dubbing for Zoids Genesis, and I can't really give my thoughts on Genesis because I've never seen Zoids Genesis. I do know that we are getting a fifth Zoids series called Zoids Wild. I am looking forward to it. I like the designs, and I'm hoping it gets localized because we need more mechs. We need more mecha in our diet. We need our healthy dosage of giant robot laser shooting dinosaurs in our diet. Anyway, so now we are fighting Pit Cloud in his Liger Zero, the Zoid that he actually pilots, and Lita in the Deep Bison. Thing that's worth pointing out. Lena pilots the D-Bison early on in the show, but later on, she ditches the D-Bison for a Zoid that makes you question her logic. It's pretty much, it's like the Lloyda situation all over again, because for those who don't know, in Tales of Symphonia, a game that I've never played, but I have seen a playthrough of, apparently, Lloyd can be described as this. If a sword has 100% power, then two swords would have 200% power. That's how dumb Lloyd is. But anyway, let's just start the battle. As I should mention, this wasn't the first time I attempted at recording this. This is actually my second attempt, because first time I did this, battery died in this exact same battle. So, Vega killed them all. Alright, D-Bison. Thing of note about the D-Bison. They're slow, but they hit like a damn tank because ow, 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 ow. Yeah, I'm using the weapon binder because the weapon binder freaking rocks, of course. Ow, 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 ow. Pretty much dual laser cannons. Yoink! Avoid the leg of zero. Boink. And get the leg of zero off. Vega, where the hell are you? Running, 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 running. Because... ow. Biff, I love doing that. Whenever they go for a melee attack, I just like to counter them. Stab, stab, and stab. I love the Berserk Fury, if you haven't guessed already. Did I mention how glad I am to be back on YouTube again? After, like, hell of a month break. I'm thinking for my schedule for this Let's Play would be once or so a week. I don't know how I want to do this, but anything can go. Again, I just want to express what I like. Next opponent, Jack Sisko and Harry Champ. Question. Am I the only one who thinks Jack Sisko kind of looks like Solid Snake? Am I the only one who thinks that? Am I the only one who thinks Jack Sisko kind of looks like Solid Snake? I sure as hell think so. But anyway, so our next opponent is going to be Jack on the Lightning Sykes and the Cannon Tortoise. Piloted by Harry. I'm just going to say this right now. The thing about this game for... I'm going to get into my gripes in the next part. But I will say this. I'm not too big of a fan of the Lightning Sykes. If I'm going to be personally honest, not really too big of a fan of the Lightning Sykes. I think this feels like a good place to end the part so far. So... that wraps up the first part of Zoey's Battle Legends. If you enjoyed, like, comment, subscribe, all the other stuff that other guys will tell you or beg. But I ain't pleading. I ain't on my knees. I ain't gonna judge. So, again, like, comment, subscribe. All that jazz, because I'm new at this. So, till then, see you guys later.